Welcome to Offshore Wind Explained by DNV Digital Solutions. My name is Runa and I'm the Marketing and Communication Manager, and I'm thrilled to have you with us today as we're presenting our new video series. The global market for offshore wind is growing rapidly and is playing a vital role when it comes to achieving a climate neutral and renewable future. We know that navigating the complexities of offshore wind might be challenging, and the questions are many. We're getting tons of questions through our webinars, our landing pages, and other events and other activities. And now I've gathered some of our experts to answer these frequently asked questions for you. So the upcoming weeks, we are answering some clear answers to offshore wind, and the five first episodes are focusing on floating offshore wind. So whether you are curious about our technology, the benefits of our software, or the future of offshore wind, we got you covered. So let's go and meet our first presenter. So today I have Jens with me, which is one of the presenters for one of the episodes. Jens, welcome.
Thank you.
Can you tell a little bit about what you're presenting in your episode?
Absolutely. So I'll be diving into the differences between time domain and frequency domain methods for floating offshore wind substructure analysis. We have several new workflows for this available now in Sesam. We know that computational performance and analysis speed is really key for our customers, and these new workflows are really addressing that point. So I'm looking forward to be talking more about this.
I'm very much looking forward to seeing your episode and to learn more. And if you, as a viewer, want to learn more about fixed offshore wind, floating offshore wind, or turbine design, then you can comment below and we will try and answer your questions as soon as possible. Thank you for watching.